What is with Hasbro and all these wave figures?
Hello, my baby! Hello, my honey! Hello, my ragtime gal! Send me a kiss, my wife! Baby, my heart's on fire!
I know I said I didn't collect many of the robots in disguise figures, but that means that I do have some. And that now includes Blast Wave, a deluxe figure from the Combiner Force subline. Having made a Bludgeon figure, Hasbro just couldn't resist repainting it. But whereas Bludgeon is popular and the figure is very hard to find, Blastwave, his blue Autobot wannabe, is clotting shelves worldwide. The box shows off the figure well enough with character art on the front and on the side panel. The back shows photos of the figure in both modes, but the bulk of the panel is devoted to boring multilingual copyright crap and instructions on how to install the smartphone app that was made for this toy line. They crammed the transformation instructions into this diagram on the back panel, so dust off your magnifying glass or you'll never make it through this. Let us open Blastwave and review him properly. Out of box, Blastwave comes with a sword accessory, and that's it. Many have said that this mold is too small, but I think it's just fine. It's certainly comparable in size to other deluxe tank transformers. Even without Bludgeon's color scheme, the blue and brown colors with yellow highlights seem to suit him well. The tank barrels are removable and therefore can be said to be accessories, but who's going to remove his tank barrels? Nobody, that's who. Pew pew, bang bang. He does a decent job of hiding the robot parts, except for the forearms, which are very glaringly visible at the back. Even being able to turn them over would have been nice, so the fingers aren't so out there. The cow catcher at the front looks pretty cool, but it's only the fact that this is expected to be an alien tank that saves it from being kind of crummy. The treads are purely cosmetic and don't work at all. Flimsy plastic wheels are on the bottoms, but even so, the tank doesn't roll very well. From the back, the tank mode looks pretty hollow, actually. On the plus side, the turret will swivel 360 degrees. The sword will store on top, and there are two other peg holes atop the treads which can be used to store the sword. You may also plug any other gun from any other Transformers line into these peg holes to top off his fearsome appearance, although plugging anything into the side treads will mean that you cannot rotate the turret. Transforming the figure is simpler than the instructions would lead you to believe, if you can read them. Remove the sword accessory and also remove the gun barrel accessories. You will see this gray hinge on the sides of the treads. Unhinge them and fold them inwards to form the robot legs. The treads also plug into the cow catcher here at the side. Untab them, fold down this blue section at the side to become the kneecaps, and complete the leg by rotating the knees downwards. Go up to the top of the tank turret. You kind of have to wrestle it apart a little bit until it splits open. But once you separate them, you can hinge them outwards, and they have a fairly long hinge that will allow you to splay them outwards without too much resistance. Once these have been separated, flip up the front of the chest, rotate the elbow sections down and outwards, and rotate the arms until the elbow is pointing forwards. From this section here, flip up the robot head, and rotate it so that it is facing forwards. In robot mode, Blastwave seems to have identical molding to Bludgeon. The panel art might make you think that he was sculpted differently, but no. He has the same skull face with samurai helmet and codpiece, the same skully look to his chest. In fact, the only differences are in the colors. The QR code is now tucked here on the arm. There is a peg hole here on the back, so that you may take the tank barrels and plug them into his back, Onslaught style. And tell me who doesn't look better with two big guns sticking up from behind their back. You may also take the tank barrels, flip the peg downwards, and plug them into either one of his hands to serve as weapons. The sword accessory will also plug into either hand for that master ninja look. The sword can also be re-plugged into these holes at the sides of the shins to make it look like he is carrying them in some sort of sheath or scabbard. He has a cool military/commander-style look to him, which is becoming to a figure that stole it from Bludgeon. Even though Robots in Disguise is more or less a kid's show, they still have a lot of articulation packed into their figures. The head will rotate 360 degrees. The shoulders will waggle slightly forwards and backwards, and have a strong ratchet inside them, so that you may tip them upwards and outwards slightly for a more football-esque appearance. Hot one, hot two. Below the shoulder pad, the arms are hinged and will swivel in and out. They will also rotate freely on their peg. Upper bicep swivel is included, and the arm will bend 90 degrees at the elbow. He comes with full waist rotation, which is a welcome addition, and despite having the cowcatcher as a sort of rear-end skirt, his ball-socketed hips will allow him to kick forward and backwards to a surprisingly wide range, and he can splay his legs in and out fairly well. He will bend over 90 degrees at the knee, although there is no foot articulation to speak of, his feet are fairly wide and will support a lot of difficult stances, so he will be able to do a lot of Metallicato-style stances. Here is Robots in Disguise Blast Wave next to Transformers Prime Beast Hunter Shockwave. Here is Robots in Disguise Blast Wave next to Generations Deluxe Warpath. Here is Blast Wave next to Titans Return Voyager Megatron / Doomshot. And here is Blast Wave next to my Mystery Science Theater 3000 coffee mug. Once you get over the kiddie nature of the Robots in Disguise series, you find that most of the figures aren't half bad. Blast Wave / Bludgeon is one of the better ones, at least stepping away from the silly animal theme that most of them went with. Positives include solid robot and alt modes, with decent playability and articulation. He looks pretty cool and holds up well under normal play. Negatives include some hollowness to the tank mode, he doesn't roll well, his head pops off unless you do everything just right, and he is kind of small for a tank, and they're not fooling anybody into thinking that this isn't just Bludgeon with blue parts. Blast Wave therefore earns 7 out of 10 deaths.
If you refuse me, honey, you lose me, then you'll be left alone. Oh, baby, tell me more, and tell me I'm your own.